shave of four students at a private school in Bengaluru. Class panel falls on them from the fourth floor. Two students left severely injured. Army colonel arrested in Shimla over the alleged gang rape of the daughter of a lieutenant colonel. The colonel and friends allegedly drugged the 21-year-old and gang raped her. It is a mega Miranao impact. Kota Municipal Corporation rolls back the outrageous proposal for a sanitation tax. Outstation students still no longer be taxed. And Haryana government takes note of the exorbitant charges at Fortis Hospital, forms an inquiry team to probe the 16 lakh rupee bill, team to submit report in 3 days.
Basically, the students have been taken as lab rats.
Every single day, I'm getting a call that, ma'am, my results are not yet out. Please help me out.
There are many students who have lost their scholarships and they have lost their whole 1 year.
Experiments have been done on us.
I am there to help them out. But what is the authority doing?
Still around 12,000 of the students' re-evaluation results are yet to be declared by the university. In the last few months, we have seen a series of goof-ups that have happened within the university campus premises, which has directly impacted thousands and thousands of students' future.
हमने सूचना के अधिकार की तो जानकारी मांगी थी कि जो Meritech कंपनी है, उसने कितना पेमेंट के लिए दावा किया है और उसके बिहाफ में कितना पेमेंट मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी ने दिया है। तो हमें जो जानकारी दी है उन्होंने दो बिल सबमिट किए थे जो 4 करोड़ 20 लाख के करीब थे जिसमें से 1 करोड़ 18 लाख रुपए यूनिवर्सिटी ने उन्हें दिए हैं।
गूफ अप नंबर वन, ओवर 5 लाख स्टूडेंट्स रिजल्ट्स आर डिलेड। गूफ अप नंबर टू, आंसर पेपर्स को मिसिंग। गूफ अप नंबर थ्री, डिस्पाइट द सैकिंग ऑफ द वाइस चांसलर, ओवर 12,000 re-evaluation results are still delayed. Now, here's a question we're asking. Despite the number of goof-ups here at the Mumbai University, who will clean up the mess? In fact, I'm joined in by students who have been supporting their fellow students, who've been supporting people who have now taken up the re-evaluation and are protesting against the fact that their results are delayed. Now, I'm just going to be getting to you a couple of voices. We're also live on Facebook at this point in time. Do join us in the conversation. If you can tell us the kind of protests that we've seen over the last couple of months and the kind of mess we've seen in this university itself. And now, over 12,000 re-evaluation results are delayed. What does that tell you, despite the fact that the Vice Chancellor was sacked a month ago? Nothing has changed on
the problem is that the Vice Chancellor created this mess, the ex-Vice Chancellor to say. And then the administration was replaced, the Vice Chancellor was sacked after the protest. So ABVP did a mass protest and then they talked with the governor, they had to talk with the governor as well as the education minister, and then the VC was sacked. And the administration also. The next problem was that people were appointed on a temporary basis. They needed to understand the mess. Then they need to do work on that. They tried, we had a conversation with them, you know, and we tried our best, to take out the results as soon as possible. But the problem was that already such a big mess was happened under the ex-Vice Chancellor that it was really not possible to take the burden, as well as the company, Meritech. So they messed up so badly in doing that online thing. It created a chaos. And after that, the quick solution could not be possible because they needed to check every person's result and papers and stuff like that. And then many papers got misplaced. So that was the problem. So it took time and it's still taking time because
after... In fact, I'm going to point out at a couple of goof-ups. We've seen how a top, ranker was marked absent as well. We've seen answer papers go missing as well. But my point is that now, after all of this, re-evaluation results are still delayed. So what does that have to say about the way things are handled in the university?
You know what, if the, as we know, the revaluation results are, they are not being put up and they have been delayed. The one, first and the foremost reason is the papers have been misplaced. Revaluation, the idea of revaluation comes out when they have the papers. Since they don't have the papers in hand, how can someone revaluate the paper? So that is the big problem right now. And that is creating another mess, and it is having a ripple effect, which is, you know, taking this university under the ground. And right now, nobody is taking the responsibility of this mess. Nobody is there in the department who can say, yeah, I'm answerable, because nobody is. Everybody is saying, go to this person, go to that person. Are we students supposed to go here and there and not study? Is this the way we should be handled? This should be taken at a serious concern, and since we know that the Vice Chancellor has not been appointed yet, and the other officials, they are supposed to be appointed in the coming few months, I think the other results to be checked in a proper manner, the authorities should be first replaced by the proper authorities. I think that is the main problem right now.
In fact, I'm going to come to that in just a bit, but here's another question. Another demand that students here had was really to ensure that the online assessment system is not continued. But that we've noticed through the RTI activists who exposed this recently is continuing for re-evaluation as well.
Actually, है क्या कि सबसे ज़्यादा समस्या यहाँ पे है फैकल्टी मेंबर की कमी है विद्यापीठ में, और फैकल्टी मेंबर जब तक नहीं रहेगा तब तक टीम वर्क नहीं होगा, और टीम वर्क नहीं होगा तो मुंबई विद्यापीठ में 18 लाख स्टूडेंट पढ़ते हैं, और इतने बड़े स्टूडेंट को एक साथ लाना, समय पर रिजल्ट देना बिना टीम वर्क के तो यहाँ पर संभव नहीं है। तो यूनिवर्सिटी प्रशासन को फैकल्टी मेंबर तो सबसे पहले ज़रूरी है रखना। जब तक फैकल्टी मेंबर नहीं आएगी, टीम वर्क नहीं होगा, तब तक रिजल्ट के ऐसे ही लगने वाले हैं और ऐसे ही प्रॉब्लम होंगे। और ख़ास तौर से क्या है कि यहाँ पे मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी के जो यहाँ पे जब तक सेंट्रलाइज नहीं होता है, यहाँ पे लोकल पॉलिटिक्स थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा हो गया है यूनिवर्सिटी में, तो जब तक सेंट्रलाइज नहीं होगा तब तक यहाँ पे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर भी नहीं आएगा, प्रशासन भी उस लेवल के नहीं आएंगे, और जब तक ये सारी चीज़ें नहीं होती तब तक मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी की स्थिति ऐसे ही बनी रहेगी।
एक और चीज़ ये भी है कि बॉम्बे हाईकोर्ट की डायरेक्टिव के despite the directive of the Bombay High Court, दो बार miss हो चुके हैं, deadlines miss हो चुके हैं results declare करने में, और अभी आपको डर है कि ये online assessment system अगर फिर से आगे लेके जाएंगे बहुत सारे goof ups और होंगे?
डेफिनेटली जो पहला जो प्रॉब्लम्स क्रिएट हुए हैं फर्स्ट टर्म के जो असेसमेंट्स हुआ है उसमें इतनी प्रॉब्लम्स ऑलरेडी क्रिएट हुए हैं कि वही अब तक सॉल्व नहीं हुए हैं। अगर हम फिर से ऑनलाइन प्रोसेस में जाते हैं तो वो जो सिस्टम था हमारा, अगर वो रिजॉल्व अब तक नहीं हो पाया तो सेम प्रॉब्लम्स विल बी देयर इन द सेकेंड टर्म असेसमेंट पेपर्स ऑल्सो। सो जब तक वो सिस्टम को पूरा रीअरेंज नहीं कर लिया जाता, आई थिंक ऑनलाइन प्रोसेस को थोड़ा सा हम लोग होल्ड पे रख सकते हैं। आई गेस
क्या आपको लगता है, आई एम गोना गेट इन सम मोर वॉइसेस, क्या आपको लगता है कि ये दिस द रीज़न वाई दिस इज़ हैपनिंग इज बिकॉज अभी तक एक परमानेंट वाइस चांसलर अपॉइंट नहीं किया गया?
आप बोलिए। यस, परमानेंट वाइस चांसलर प्लेज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन टेकिंग द डिसीजंस, बट due to this mess ex vice chancellor was sent on leave for few days because of such a mess was happened here. So according to as soon as a new vice chancellor were elected, they should have taken proper decisions, and they should work with proper planning and team management to take the results out as soon as possible.
Now, considering you study, you're not affected, of course, through the kind of goof ups that we've seen. आप अफेक्टेड नहीं हो, लेकिन आप यहाँ पे पढ़ते हो, आपने अपने यू नो दूसरे लोगों के साथ भी आपने देख चुके हैं कि कितने सारे गूफ अप्स हुआ है इन द लास्ट कपल ऑफ मंथ्स। क्या आपके मन में ये डर है कि ये आपके साथ भी हो सकता है?
ऑफकोर्स हो सकता है, क्योंकि एक फ्रेश एग्जांपल है, मेरा जो फ्रेंड है जिसने ग्रेजुएशन कम्प्लीट किया जस्ट नाउ, उसे 2 साल ड्रॉप लगने के बाद रिवॉल्यूशन का उसका रिजल्ट KT एग्ज़ाम के बाद आया था, तो इससे उसका वेस्ट ऑफ मनी तो हो गया, ऊपर से रिवॉल्यूशन का रिजल्ट भी उसके KTA पेपर के बाद मिला, उसमें भी वो फेल था। तो ऐसे ये होते हैं, प्रॉब्लम्स होते हैं, तो इसी से मेरे भी मार्क्स सेफ है या करेक्ट है ये मैं जान नहीं सकता।
Let me go across quickly to Richa now, who's standing by with more details. Richa, you've been tracking this. What is the word coming in from the Education Minister, Vinod Tavde, considering, there have been several goof-ups in this university, and despite the Bombay High Court's directive, nothing has been fixed?
That's right, Amita. We have been tracking this case from morning now, and right from the Mumbai University till the Education Minister Vinod Tavde himself, the attitude that we got to see was extremely callous and casual. Even in this moment when about 12,000 of these revaluation results are still pending. And when I myself went ahead to approach Vinod Tavde, who being the Education Minister, the one word that he used while answering the question about why there is such a delay and why there is so many goof-ups that are happening, he said that this is a very routine thing that happens every single year. Specifically, when I asked him about the revaluation aspect, and when we asked him how soon will you actually regularize and maintain the university's decorum as well as the process in which it is going right now of the various goof-ups that have happened in the last 6 to 7 months, to which he answered that we do not interfere in the affairs of the university and you should go ahead and ask this question to the Mumbai University officials. So you can clearly see that the tone in which the education minister, who has been in charge of the portfolio of handling the education in the state, he himself does not seem to care about the fact that the future of so many students is at stake currently, and he is not giving us a right answer neither. He is coming on camera to speak on this matter.
Will you be able to come? Can also take us through the kind of ordeal the students have at this point in time. Over 12,000 results are still delayed. What is the plan of action now for these students, considering they've lost 1 year already?
Yes, Amita, certainly the students are in left in a lurch right now, because many of these students are losing out a year and many of their exams were postponed or delayed, and many of them are even waiting for the revaluation results to come out so that they can actually move forward. A lot of these students had actually applied for jobs and also their further studies outside the country, which is also still pending, and already they have lost another year, and now they are hoping that this revaluation exam results should come out at the earliest so that their future, which is at stake currently, can actually move forward and they do not have to suffer, which they already are suffering, but they do not have to suffer even further, because the university till now has a lot of mending to be done when it specifically comes to the students who are currently suffering on account of this delays that are happening constantly from many months now.
Also, Richa, take us through the conversation that you had with the RTI activist Anil Galgali, who has pointed out the fact that now, despite the fact that this online assessment system did not work, it has been used for re-evaluation as well.
That's right, Amita. When we had a conversation with RTI activist Anil Galgali, who actually had put in an RTI for this company, which is Meritrack, and whose official statement also we have taken and we have put up as well. He categorically went on to state that despite the fact that this company which came into working from the month of April and May, that's when it started, despite the fact that there were a series of goof-ups and the exchange of papers, the wrong papers were scanned, students' exam sheet went missing, despite this fact, again, the government and the university does not seem to care, and the tender and the contract seems to have still continued. And the amount of money that the government till now had paid up to Meditrack is about 1 crore and 18 lakhs, which clearly shows that at least currently, when we even went to the university premises, the university's word was also that they cannot discontinue the contract till it finishes 1 year. So it seems like even for the upcoming revaluation processes and the exams that will take place, this particular company will continue with the work. And maybe the students are hoping that, and they fear as well, that the same thing should not repeat itself and work needs to be done properly and the results need to come out on time.
Absolutely, Richa. In fact, before we let you go, if you can also tell us whether the students who are affected will continue to protest here at the premises of Mumbai University.
That's right, Amita. The students have been protesting constantly at the university premises, and even today we spoke to them in the morning to know what their views are in this matter, and they only want that the university should put up their acts properly now and work towards the welfare of the students and not try to cover up the act and face and put up the and accept their mistakes and the errors that they have made. And despite the two deadlines that they have already missed that was given to them by the Bombay High Court, it is high time that the students want that the suffrage ends and now the results should be out and the necessary steps should be taken to stop this company, this particular company who has been granted this contract of conducting this online assessment. If they are not able to do the work properly, somebody else should be hired to do this job.
All right, Richa, many thanks for getting us those details. In fact, like Richa was pointing out, let's also listen in to the RTI activist Anil Galgali and students who are actually missing out on a year and who have not yet got their results.
मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी ने जो मेरिटेक कंपनी को करीब 1,18,00,000 रुपए देने का काम किया है, जिस कंपनी की वजह से पूरा ब्लंडर हुआ। एक जगह सरकार ने वहाँ के जो वीसी थे उसे निकालने का काम किया है, लेकिन जिस कंपनी की वजह से पूरा मामला हुआ है वहाँ कहीं ना कहीं तो उसे बचाने का काम सरकार भी कर रही है, मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी भी कर रही है। हमारा इतना ही कहना है कि जिस कंपनी को जिस तरह से टेंडर के लिए सभी जो उसके नियम थे, जो अलग अलग जो उसके रूल्स थे, उसे उन्होंने कहीं ना कहीं तो बदल करके उसे मदद करने का भी पहले काम किया और उसके बाद उसे बड़े पैमाने पर पेमेंट भी दे रहे हैं। हमने राज्यपाल को भी पत्र लिखा है कि इस कंपनी को ब्लैकलिस्ट किया जाए, उसे जुर्माना लिया जाए और आने वाले दिनों में जो भी कंपनी अच्छा रिजल्ट दे सकती है उसका सरकार एक रिव्यू करे और उसके बाद काम दे, ताकि जो आने वाले दिनों में ऑनलाइन जो असेसमेंट जो सिस्टम है वो कभी प्रभावित ना हो और इस साल जो तकलीफ हुई है वो अगले साल तकलीफ ना हो।
Basically, the students have been taken as lab rats. So experiments have been done on us. And unfortunately, it's been already 6-7 months that the main results are not out. Many courses yet, the main results were not out. And this company, Meritrack, why don't you just blacklist this company? Rather than blacklisting the company, the university is going on paying them money.
There are many students who have lost their scholarships and they have lost their whole 1 year because university has not declared their results on time. And still, imposing fine on Meritrack, university are clearing their bills.
बहुत सारे ऐसे problems हैं जो EMA वाले हैं और उनके पास ऐसी बहुत सारी बातें आई हैं कि बहुत सारे लोगों के कापियाँ जो हैं गायब कर दी गई हैं और फिलहाल वो रजिस्ट्रार वगैरह इन सारे लोगों के पास अगर जा रहे हैं तो अपने कमरे को बंद करके और बाकायदे अंदर बैठे हुए हैं और सीधा एक बात कह रहे हैं कि मुझे किसी से मिलने के लिए ना दिया जाए और मैं किसी से मिलना नहीं चाहता।
Well, a couple of things we're asking here on Pulse on Mirror. Now, who is going to clean up the mess here at Mumbai University? Why isn't the company Meritrack blacklisted already? Like one of the students was pointing out, we're live on Facebook. Do join in the conversation. In fact, we have one student who is about to lose out on a year. If you could take us through what exactly happened.
I'm in currently 5-4. So previously, there were 3 exams that I was missing on. So the reval result I was waiting for only, and my exam was yesterday itself. So they told me like, you give your KT exam and with the reval result it will come, so we will accordingly see to it. But then it took a really long time, so I was about to file a writ also. I did it, but that day the result came out. So I passed with like 45 score, that's what they gave. Then the second exam was my another exam. I appeared for the exam. I got 25. Despite I'm very sure I cannot score below 60 in that exam because I'm a first division student and I'm very sure about. Then I applied for the reval as per the procedure. So after the reval, they awarded with 5 marks to me. And I told them before that also that my 36 mark sheets are missing. That clearly shows my supplements are missing. So they said, agar supplements milengi, we'll give it to you, we'll give the marks to you, rest we'll see to it. And then there was an article that came out that average students are what were the average marks and all that news was there in the news. So I was very disheartened that people who are working so hard, they're not getting the marks that they deserve and they're randomly checking paper. Even the people there in the university have accepted that professors are not the one like we are looking for. They're not properly checking the answers. They're giving answers as they want to it. That's completely wrong. That's not fair for students like us. We are working hard the whole year just for this one exam, and the professors who are checking the exams, they are not well educated according to it. I should not say that, I'm sorry, but yeah, they have accepted it that yes, professors, we are not getting professors here, so we are just taking people who have BLS, LLB pass and all that. But that is not correct because our careers are at stake. So is that our fault that the supplements are missing, the answers we have written are correctly written, but you're not giving us marks? Is that our fault? Is that your fault? Firstly, they don't accept their faults. They're like a long procedure. They give it to us. Fill this form, fill that form, go here, go there. It's like a very long procedure.
And then how much running around did you have to do? And does it concern you at some point that the company still continues to have a tie-up with the university?
Nothing of that sort. Like a principal also, he helped us out. He said, I'll write a letter and I'll say that these are the students who are facing this problem. But then also nothing of that sort happened. I have this whole complete file that I made. For like 10 days, I was working on the same thing. My dad came here. He was struggling, came here to help me. But when he saw the functioning, he was tired. He's like, what is happening in this? Because it was never like this. I have studied in this university. First 2 years, I was here. And now I don't know what has happened to this university. Drastically a big change, an online procedure that they check the marks and all that, but that has not really worked out. That has really not worked with us.
Absolutely. Taking on from her point, you've heard of a lot of other cases from your batchmates as well who've been through this, and the fact is that this company continues to have a tie-up. So does it concern you that it's not been blacklisted, there's no action taken?
Exactly. And I also had a word with Meritrek officials. The problem is that they're so much lagging behind. They don't know where the result will come. They have a system wherein the company uploads the result. So they don't know where the result will come. They don't know it. And the problem is, even if you want to put a system online, okay, good idea. There should be a mind behind implementation. It should happen in a patchwork, batch-wise. You cannot put whole lakhs of papers on the online system. That is not how it happens. Plus, a company who has goofed up so badly, you're again appointing it. I mean, first of all, the company should have been fined drastically for their goof up, and then you're again doing it. At least, and I will plead the controller and the exam system from ABVP that please, if you're doing it, do it patch wise. First of all, when you think of an idea, understand the idea, understand the system, and then do it. Don't do it just because you want to do it.
In fact, Ashish Joshi here says CM Devendra Fadnavis should take responsibility. Mohan Kumar says education systems totally mishandled. Does it concern you also at some level that the education minister perhaps has not taken enough cognizance of the problems here and the number of goofs?
People are filing writs here and action has been taken like in 3 days, the work's done. People who are following the procedure, they are lagged behind. Like they're telling 10 days, 15 days, a month. Like they're just like being that casual about it. So if they want us to approach the court, we'll surely do it. Because if a writ is doing that much effort that within 3 days the result's out, I think that's the easiest way to approach the court. Because the High Court will tell them that take the results out. And if the person is in like whatever marks is there, they'll pass it with a good score. That's what my friends have done. They filed writs and the results are still out. I didn't file a writ because of which my result is still not out.
We have just about 30 seconds left then. What is your major demand, if you can tell us?
My major demand is, if you are trying to implement a new policy like online thing, but you should at least do it properly so that the students are not students should not suffer for that. And despite here, there are many cases that people are saying that my supplements are missing, my this is missing, my that is missing, and they are not actually taking any action against it. They're like, fill this form, fill that form. They're just making us roam around here and there, but not directly solving a problem.
That is the word coming in from students here at Mumbai University, extremely distressed with the number of goof-ups that have taken place, really saying that the government should take note, the education minister should take cognizance, more importantly, the company, the action against the company should be taken. This is Amita Balachandra signing off on Pulse. Stay with us.